Hey, Tyr. Thanks. And I'm sorry about before.
No. I am sorry. I should never have come. We shouldn't linger.
Look, I just want to do the right thing. And according to prophecy...
Speak no more of prophecy.
War will not give you the purpose you seek, Atreus. Only slaughter.
So what are we supposed to do? Roll over? Do nothing?
Enough! We will discuss our next move when we are out of danger.
Dark Elf Assault. How fortuitous.
I'm so sick of fighting Elf. Can't they just leave us alone?
Incoming! Right side!
Fight!
They're this way.
Let's keep moving.
Keep pushing forward.
Can we leave now, please?
Almost there. This way. Tyr, we...
Open the gateway, please.
You
want war.
Atreus, see for yourself the legacy this one has left for the Barons. I've had far more than I can stomach.
We do not need to rush. We should see this desert for ourselves.
Look, I know we can't trust prophecy, but I'm not sure we should just ignore what we saw either.
We are not ignoring it. We will discuss it back home. For now, I wish to search for the wounded animal you heard earlier.
You? Really?
Yeah.
Well, okay then. Good. Yeah, lead the way.
We should be able to reach the Barons up top. Once we find a way past this hive matter.
I remember these things. Definitely Dark Elf territory. Father, is it always moral to kill something that's trying to kill you?
Yes.
Well, there you have it, lad. Hail, fellow travelers!
Atreus heard a creature in pain in the desert.
Over a storm like this? Most impressive.
You know Alfheim pretty well, right? Do you have any idea what's out there?
No, sorry. The elves and I... long story, but it's best when we keep out of each other's way. Hive matter is... stickier than I care for. Good luck on your search, though. Stuff some cloth in your ears to keep the sand out. Don't knock it till you've tried it. This axe just keeps getting stronger. Have we more to talk about?
What are these animals?
Gulon, native to Vanaheim. Not sure what they're doing here.
Someone trained them to pull a sled. Lucky for us.
Domesticated Gulon. Most unusual. Any particular direction to find your wounded animal? Or are we just enjoying the weather?
I can't hear anything out here.
Perhaps we'll find a cave first to catch our bearings? Not getting up there with all this sand in your way.
So much sand. I don't think we're getting through that gate in this storm.
Watch your legs!
Perhaps we should show it to one of the dwarves. They'll know what to do with it.
Horn.
Thing is, I think the animal's inside.
Whatever's inside is kicking up quite a bit of sand.
How do we reach it?
There's caves and tunnels aplenty out here. Let's find one and see where it takes us.
Ah!
There's too much sand in the way, brother. Can't read it.
Look, there's a cave entrance.
Underneath the desert. Is the creature within?
Yeah, sounds like it. We'll find it if we keep going. What is this place?
A refuge for the Dark Elves, by the looks of it. One of the few remaining now that they're barred from the temple.
Great.
The Twilight Stone give you the angle you need, brother.
Now that I know more about the Dark Elves, I wish we didn't have to fight them.
They attack us.
Well, this is their home. And considering what happened the last time we were in Alfheim, can you really blame them?
Patience. A virtue or a threat?
Depends on the reader. The creature you heard. What does it say now?
It's not always like that. Some animals are just... feel what they're feeling, you know? And whatever this thing is, it's in a lot of pain.
I see.
Why do you ask?
I am curious.
Really?
I am capable of curiosity.
Okay. Okay. I think we gotta hit it from the other side. Animals or enchanted rings or whatever.
Much has changed for both of us.
Well, yeah. I'm just trying to figure out why you'd help some random animal.
Is this not what you want?
No, no, it is. I'm just surprised it's what you want, too.
Abandon this creature, we will leave.
Well, no, I don't want to abandon it. But if we have to kill a bunch of Dark Elves to get there...
I remember a young lad whom, until this very moment, would take on an army of Draugr to save a wounded animal.
But these aren't undead Draugr. They're elves. I just want to make sure we're not repeating the same mistakes. Getting involved where we shouldn't. Why does it feel like no matter what we do in Alfheim, we wind up hurting Dark Elves?
We are down here to help the creature you heard.
I know that, but I'm usually the one who drags us around trying to rescue animals. Why do you care so much? Is there something you're not telling me?
No.
Okay.
Huh?
offer!
Go! Go!
He's coming! Above you!
Another nightmare! To the left!
I felt that one, brother.
What is it?
Great Gefjun's ghost! That's the largest bloody half-goof I've ever laid eyes on!
It's not just in pain. It's trying to sing.
It's the Song of the Sands. You don't normally sing like this underground.
Is that what's causing the storm?
Aye. Judging by all this hive matter weighing it down, it's been trapped here for dozens of winters.
Don't worry, Lunge. I'll get you out.
What is that name?
Well, the last squid thingy we saw was Wiener, so...
Oh, boy. While I appreciate the attempt at humor, that little brother is truly awful wordplay. Embarrassing, really.
Oh, well, can't all be winners. There's gotta be a way to clear those rocks. Get a better angle. Be off!
Yeah.
Looks like it can move now, but it still can't get out.
Much of the hive matter is gone. We can free it from the surface now.
Why did they trap it down here?
Hafgifers are known to burrow, so I'd hesitate to place full blame on our Dark Elf friends.
But it's trapped in their hive stuff.
Hive matter doesn't belong to the Dark Elves, any more than the light belongs to the Light Elves. It's just another of Alfheim's natural resources. One the Elves have used since the time of their ancestors. And while the Light Elves seem keen to banish the Hive over on their side, the Dark Elves make effective use of it out here in the Barrens.
So, by clearing out all of this Hive, are we hurting Dark Elves?
You wish to leave the creature enslaved?
No.
Then let us free it.
This is the spot! We can cut the hive Koopa loose here! It flies?
Of course it flies! It's a half Koopa!
Sounds much happier now. And hey, the storm's gone!
Aye. Perhaps we'll finally earn some goodwill from our Dark Elf friends after all.
Look, Father, thanks for bringing us out here, but you don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnarok, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered... He just wants to spend time with you, lad, while he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead, but if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
I don't know what to say. Thank you for bringing us out here. I'm glad to do this.
As am I.
soldiers we fought in Svartalfheim, those were Enriar? I thought Enriar were just spirits in Valhalla until Ragnarok came.
They were no spirits.
Indeed, brother. Odin appears to have found a loophole. Activated his forces early as a standing army. Perhaps something he could only do without any honest Valkyries around to stand in his way.
Back to Thor and Odin's story? Where were we? Okay. There was Thamor, the stonemason.
Aye. He quarreled with his son. Went into the night to find him. Found Thor instead.
And there was Thamor's son, Grimthor.
Who built the walls of Asgard. And whispered something of importance to Freya before his betrayal and assassination.
Enough. We will continue later.
I gotta remember to ask Tyr about his travels to the lands beyond the seas.
You wish to travel the world?
I don't know. Maybe. See new places. Find out more about myself. Okay, what other terrible things have Odin and Thor done? There was Groa, of course.
The Knowledge Keeper and Prophet of Ragnarok. Thor murdered her husband, and Odin covered it up before doing her in himself.
Can't forget Ymir, the first giant.
Odin carved him up to form the realms from his body, and let the torrent of his blood nearly drown every giant alive.
What about the giants of Jotunheim? They all seemed dead when we finally made it there.
That remains a mystery. Well, admittedly, it sounds like the Aesir god's dream.
What about Fjorgyn? Thor's mother was alive, wasn't she?
Indeed she was. The circumstances of her demise were murky at best, but not sure I can blame Odin for that one. He wasn't the same after.
Hold. We will finish later.
But enough of that for now.
Well, I hope Tyr's had enough time to find his equilibrium, or whatever.
Indeed. I saw flashes of the old god of war in him, but they were fleeting.
There is nothing wrong with opposing war, nor opposing prophecy.
I suppose that's fair. Never can be quite sure what the giants meant by any of it.
Am I the only one that remembers they predicted our entire journey to Jotunheim? If the giants saw Tyr leading armies at Ragnarok, and I believe them.
The question is how you'll ever make Tyr believe it.
Master Kratos, I would speak with you.
Speak.
If you are ever in need of my services and I am not present, I have installed these handy chimes for you to notify me. Simply throw your axe and strike the chimes, and I will attend to your needs. Would you care to take a practice throw? A magnificent throw, Master Kratos. Truly a seasoned pro. Very well. You know how to reach me now. Well, any questions before you travel on?
Ah, glad to see you back, young one. Come help me, won't you?
Oh, sure.